All right. Asus has just released its 11th generation of Maximus motherboards, and I am starting this season with nothing else but its entry level, the Hero Edition. This is basically the workhorse of enthusiastically driven users which are looking for something definitely beautiful, aesthetically pleasing, robust and feature-packed. So without any further ado, let's jump right in. After this. The thing you need to know about Maximus series is that it is an enthusiastically driven motherboard which aims at pleasing the craziest builders out there. If you're gonna go for a custom water cooling configuration, simple or dual loop, this is the kind of series you want to go for, and the Hero Edition is the entry level of that enthusiastic realm. And to my surprise, it did come with a bunch of new features, which some of which did surprise me. So going straight to the obvious, the ROG MAXIMUS XI Hero is an ATX motherboard, meaning 30.5 centimeter long for 24.4 centimeter wide. As usual, it is powered by an LGA 1151 CPU socket, which can support both the 8th and 9th generation of Intel iCore processors. Note that the VRMs are definitely beefier than the previous generations and can output at least double the wattage that the 10th series could, and that's because the 9th generation, and in particular the i9-9900K, needs tons of power to run optimally. So it is no surprise to see that we have larger, thicker and bigger heatsinks than on its predecessors. Memory wise, we have the usual dual channel which can support up to 64GB of DDR4 RAM, overclockable up to 4400MHz. This is much more than previously featured on its predecessors, the Hero 10, which only had up to 4133MHz overclockable RAM, and even more than these very motherboard siblings, the Prime Z390A or the Strix Z390 series, which had RAM overclockable up to 4.266MHz. So kudos to Asus for this. Staying in the memory, we have a dual M.2 solid state drive configuration, one which can support sticks up to 8cm long and one up to 11. Worth noting, the Z390 chipset, just as its predecessors, is Optane ready, meaning that both of our M.2 solid state drive can swap data up to 32 Gbps each. But with these kinds of speeds, of course we are going to face some overheating on our sticks, and that's why both of them have individual heat shields, which are also equipped with thermopads. PCIe wise, nothing surprising. We have our usual 6 third generation PCIe Expresses, 3 single slots, single speeds, and 3 16 slots with different speeds. Note that only the closest one to the CPU can feature up to 16 full bus speeds, so if you have one and only GPU to run on your computer, this is where you want it for optimal performances, and if you are going to go for a dual GPU configuration, you want it to be on those two 16 slots, and they will be sharing their bus speed to feature an 8x8 full bus speed. The last 16 slot will feature 2 or 4 full bus speed depending of the BIOS configuration. Note that because the 2 first 16 slots are most likely to carry the heavy weight of our video cards, they have been metallically reinforced. SATA wise, and as usual, this motherboard will support 6 third generation SATA plugs which can all transfer up to 6 Gbps individually, and IO wise, our motherboard features a fully integrated IO shield. And talking about IO, starting from the left, we have our BIOS and CMOS button right here, a PS2 mouse keyboard connector, 2 USB second generation connectors which can both transfer up to 480 Mbps, 4 3.1 second generation USB plugs which can transfer data up to 10 Gbps, 2 3.1 first generation USB plug which can transfer data up to 5 Gbps. Here we have our display port as well as an HDMI display output, our surge protected gigabit LAN, and here we have our usual dual band Wi-Fi adapter which comes with the not so usual 2x2 Wi-Fi MU-MIMO. I know, it's a very cute name, What does that mean? Both of our Wi-Fi antenna have individual and dedicated Wi-Fi streams. That's going to translate in better coverage, faster download speeds, and an overall improvement in connectivity. Very kudos, super kudos, triple kudos to Asus for integrating this new standard on this awesome board. Finally here, we have 5 audio channel plus optical. All right, so let's take a closer look to our connectors on our motherboard. So as usual, we have a couple of second generation USB connectors right here, which can both transfer up to 480 megabit per second. A 3.1 first generation connector right here, which can transfer up to 5 gigabit per second. And a 3.1 second generation Type-C front panel connector, which can transfer data up to 10 gigabit per second. And let's not forget our usual front panel audio connector right here. All right, so we've seen the usual suspect on this motherboard, but here come my favorite part of this review, the enthusiastic slash aesthetical part of it. And this motherboard has big shoes to fill compared to its Maximus X predecessor. And a lot of expectations coming from the enthusiastic community because, again, this motherboard supposedly should give you the very extreme of what's out there in terms of builds and should be able to support absolutely anything your money can throw at it. And of course, it does not disappoint. Starting with the fans, this motherboard can support natively up to 8 fans plus an extension which can add another 4 fans on this thing. So potentially 12 fans in the same time, and that should give you a hint on how extreme the thing is. Note that out of those 8 fans, 2 of those plugs can be used for water pumps. So yes, our ROG Maximus 11 Hero Edition can support a single or a dual custom water cooling loop configuration. Custom loop water, 1 or 2, you got it. But that is not all. Our motherboard comes with an external thermal sensor right here, a water flow sensor right here, and a water flow in and out sensor right here. Again, aiming at pleasing the most extreme builders out there. All right, so moving on, and the true mark of an enthusiastic motherboard, we have our QLED screen, which will allow us to monitor and troubleshoot our system in case of problems. Right next to it, we have our soldered button, start and reset, and a somewhat awkwardly placed MEM OK button all the way down there. That is a lot, but that's not all. Of course, this motherboard is ORA compliant. If you don't know what is ORA compliance is, well, worry not, because I got a video right about this topic. And in a nutshell, ORA compliance is basically a syncing RGB effect that will sync all your different components RGB in a harmonious way. It's been around for a while and all the big manufacturers have their own version of it. And here we have 2 ORA RGB strips hidden right under the IO chipset heat shield and under the IO roof. Woof woof. And if that's not enough, and in the case you wanted to add a bunch of different RGB strips to your build, we have 2 ORA compliant RGB connector right here and 2 RGB addressable connector right there. So there's nothing more Asus can throw at you, really nothing more. So in conclusion, this board will cost you around $290 without taxes. And again, I know this is not a cheap board, but that is not the aim of that board, because when you go into Maximus series, you're looking for the very best enthusiastic board can offer. And I've said board like 6 times in a sentence. So unapologetically not a budget board, even though it's an entry level. This is probably the best Hero motherboard I've seen. In this particular iteration, we have real advances, which was not a given knowing that the Z390 chipset is exactly the very same one that were available on the Maximus 10, the Z370 chipset. I mean, they both support the very same processors, the 8th and the 9th generation. But unlike my conclusion in the Z390 Prime A or the Strix, which I did again last week, I would argue and I would definitely advise to do the upgrade between the Maximus 10 to the Maximus 11. And that's because I've seen real advancement. First, the RAM clock going from 4,133 megahertz to 4,400 megahertz. So you have a bump of what, 5%, which is quite a lot. On top of that, we have also this new MU-MIMO thingy. And after trying it, there is no way back. I cannot go back to anything else. So really triple kudos to Asus for that. But we also have bigger VRMs and bigger heat shields on them, so you're going to be able to overclock those ninth generation of Intel processor easily up to 4.8 or 5 gigahertz without double thinking it at all. So that's really, really cool. And you know, that's one of those boards where I really have nothing bad to say. I think the price point is really fair. I think the over make of this motherboard, the build quality is beyond premium, it's absolutely perfect. And yeah, so you know what, it's a must buy. And I'm gonna feature this board on my next step-by-step build series. Instead of going to the Formula, I'm just gonna go on the Hero. It's gonna save me some money, and I think that it has absolutely everything we need to have ourselves a real cool time, or good time. And you know what I meant. All right, that said, that's it for me.